Leena, Aseem, welcome to Film Companion.
Thanks.
First things first, I have to say, after watching your film yesterday, I'm very hungry and I want to know your views on Rajma Chawal, the food, right at the start.
My favorite dish.
Oh, yeah?
It's my favorite dish and I don't know why association is with Sundays. Sunday lunch has to be Rajma Chawal. Yeah.
Absolutely.
I love how you've shown Old Delhi in the film. It's almost like it's a character in itself. A lot of filmmakers have, of course, tried to show Delhi in the past. But what were you trying to do differently and what did you want to stay really true to?
So, Chandni Chowk was such an interesting place. I've been fascinated with Chandni Chowk for many years, ever since I've been there. I studied in Delhi, so I have a nostalgia with Delhi. But Chandni Chowk, for me, felt like, okay, I want to shoot there, but it's going to be logistically really, really difficult. But once we went there, they just adopted us, you know, we became part of their family. So I don't know whether we are in their film or they are in our film. And just essentially, symbolically in the film, it lent itself to be a character because the film is about the old and the new. It's about generation gap. It's about communication gap. And the beauty about Chandni Chowk is, though it feels like it's belongs to another time, it's still so contemporary, everybody's on their mobiles and, you know, and then the wiring of that place, the whole structure of that place where it's so congested and then you open a door and you're in this really lavish haveli.
Yeah.
There's so many things about Chandni Chowk which are so, so amazing. More than anything else, it's the spirit of the people there. I mean, every day that I shot there, I said, nobody can say we are intolerant. We have so much tolerance for so many things. And so much patience. Thank you to Chandni Chowk and the people. I mean, we are completely in love with them. Mm-hmm. And I think also the way Aseem approached producing it over there, the things we got done with love, we could never pay for them.
It's a place you would never want to be there and live there. But once you go there,
you don't want to come out.
You wouldn't want to come out of it.
Like I remember Rishi Kapoor messaging us after we came back from the shoot. That I'm missing walking through the lanes because he used to like really enjoy
interact with people.
Initially, like we had a scooter which would get him in. He said, "No way, I'm sitting on the scooter."
Yeah, just 2 days.
So he would walk. He would stop at shops, have conversations,
eat.
And by the third day, Chandni Chowk stopped reacting to the fact that we were these outsiders. We became part of them.
Wow.
Yeah.
I'm sure a lot of people want to know from you guys, what does it take to pitch a film to Netflix? Like, what do you got to do? What's that process like?
We were lucky. So Netflix approached us, they wanted to watch the film. Swati called me and said,
Swati Shetty, that is. Yeah.
She said, please show me the film. That time it was not even
a thought
for us. You know, it was not an option for us. We were completing the film and looking for options for distribution. And they saw the film, they liked it. They made us an offer. And that's when we had to make this choice, you know. For Aseem, it was instant. He's like, yes, this is the best thing that can happen to this film. For me, it took a little bit of a journey because, you know, you're used to a traditional way of doing things. But then Aseem said 2 things to me. He said, Leena film zinda rahegi, which is such a big deal. And second, he said, whatever I do as a producer and whichever distributor comes on board, do you think you'll reach the audience that this gives you at an instant? And then I took a vote in my office. And across the board, it was Netflix is really cool. And that was exactly the word used. Then I said, okay, it's a film which a generation is being taught to learn technology. And that's what I should be doing as a filmmaker too. So that was my journey to deciding that, yes, this is the best platform for this film. Mm-hmm.
Did the film stem from a personal space for the both of you? Like when you were...
Though he brought me the story, so Vivek Anchalia came and told him the story and he's like, Leena, we were looking for a subject to launch Anirudh Tanwar.
Okay.
And then he said, you have to hear the story. Because obviously he also related to it and he knew I would because I have lots of stories with my father, you know, learning Facebook to stay in touch with his daughters. And just everybody that we approached for the film at for any role, you know, whether it was an actor or a technician, would first say, oh my God, this is so true. You know what my father did. You know what my mother did. So it is a subject which I think is so relatable today to everybody across the world, just not in India. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. I mean, me and my father, we share more on Facebook than anywhere else.
Yeah.
Yeah, they have more conversations on Facebook.
Yeah, he's a busy man. So yeah, he likes, shares this, that. So we keep knowing, we keep learning about each other from Facebook, too many things.
Wow.
So social media, yeah.
And here you are directing someone as established as Rishi Kapoor and a debutant in Anirudh. Did you see yourself directing the two of them differently just to get the best out of them, or what was that like?
So my individual process with every actor is different, has to be different. Mm-hmm. Because every actor needs a different kind of
approach.
Some want to work internally, with some I work more externally. So that's something I think you just have to gauge as a director. But on set, and this is a process that I do actually much before I go on set.
Okay.
So with Anirudh, I worked a lot before we went on set. And on set, he was Kabir through and through. I think the credit on set would go to Rishi Kapoor because he has this childlike energy. And he is a newcomer in lots of ways, in his attitude.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I don't know where he hides all the wisdom that he actually has about filmmaking, about being generations in the film industry. You know, he brought the correct energy and it just didn't feel like I was, you know, in the same frame directing somebody so established and experienced and somebody so new. And also the spirit of Anirudh, who came with a maturity to the job.
Yeah.
And Rishiji, I mean, he makes the other actors comfortable. People, because it's very natural for people to be in awe of him.
Intimidated a little bit, yeah.
Yeah, but he somehow he just takes that away.
And I think in Rajma Chawal, it was, and the film is about relationships. I think we had such a beautiful team that I don't think any day of work felt like work to anybody, you know. And then we were in Chandni Chowk, so we were eating all the time. So it was the film, I don't know, it just got made.
Got made.
I don't know whether I really made it. It just happened.
You spoke
about... Our team is still, I mean, you can see Shubham here. I mean, it's been so long. The film has finished now. It's 1 year that we shot.
We're still all together.
All of us are together every day. We hang out together in the office.
You spoke about the amazing team. How did it help you to have like an international crew when it came to cinematography and editing? How did that elevate the film? Why was that necessary?
Perspective.
So... this I did in Teenpatti, I got an editor from LA. Then in Parched, I shot the film with Russell Carpenter and Kevin Tent edited the film. What I learned was, I think I would like to work with technicians from across the world because it just brings a different lens to the same story. And that helps making the story bigger because at the end of the day, even if you're culturally bound,
mm-hmm.
it's about emotions and everybody reacts to emotions.
Human emotions, yeah.
You know, and I think an outside perspective makes me also question something. If I was saying it in a particular way, I can say it in a different way, which largens the scope of understanding it. So that's what...
driving the point home.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And also looking at a location which we're not reacting to it that much because you're used to it.
Yeah.
Somebody else is like, oh my God, this is so fascinating.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know, and then for them to bring that fascination to the lens is so interesting. And at an editing level, again, it's just a slight shift in grammar and they all get it. Because things that the editor doesn't understand, he'll ask me, he said, no, what is happening here exactly?
Right. I remember you telling me this when I was talking to you at the time of when we were producing Parched, that, and I questioned you why. You said, because I'm writing the film again.
Yeah, so it's like rewriting your film. Editing is a stage where you rewrite the film. So whenever the editor, he questions me, I'm like, this is what we are saying. He's like, okay. So that's not coming across. So we just need to say it a bit differently. And so for me, that made me realize that just bringing in another perspective, a foreign perspective, just largens the scope of telling the same story.
Yeah.
Also, as Hindi-speaking people for a Hindi film, we take a lot of things for granted. If you are trying to reach an international audience, you also need to understand their perspective.
Yeah.
Hence.
And finally, you talked about how Netflix approached you, but now I want to know from you guys, has this really broadened up the approach to filmmaking and made it easier for you to tell stories? Do you see yourself consciously looking at digital releases going forward?
Absolutely, absolutely. It's
they've converted you?
They've converted you. No, but... It's not like theatres will disappear for me. I think both will coexist. But you have a wider selection of which content will... It'll be an experiment.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you'll learn through time. I think both will coexist beautifully. I don't ever want theatres to disappear. But this platform has, you know, increased the audience so much that every content will find its
space.
Audience. So now we'll be you know, telling stories without the boundaries of, you know, we have only this kind of an audience.
Language, I mean, you can transcend beyond your boundaries of language, boundaries of culture. So you're not cottage industries anymore.
Mm-hmm.
Netflix provides you with that.
And, you know, learning about a new culture through films is so much more interesting because you see, you live the lives with them.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
So that's what we're doing. Thank you so much for chatting with me and
Thank
all
you.
The best for the release
Thank you.
On
Thank
Netflix. Thanks.
I hope you enjoyed Rajma Chawal.
I did. Thank you.
Thank you.